Hi everybody, it's the interview queen, Alicia Atoot here, and I'm hopping on your screens to say subscribe now to Warriors of Wrestling. They have tons of awesome content, awesome matches, awesome wrestlers on their channel. So again, subscribe, like, comment on the videos, and of course, hit that notification bell. Interview queen out.
Welcome back to Warriors of Wrestling. It is November, and we are marching towards the conclusion of the 2020 Warriors season. Tonight, we present Road to Solution, the Warriors series. But as we talk about Solution, next month, our anniversary show, right here in this building, Final Solution. We're gonna have a title match, one that was hard earned by this next gentleman, and he's gonna sign the contract right here in front of all these people this evening. Are you ready? Then let's have our contract signing for Final Solution, the heavyweight championship match. Let's bring him out first. He was the winner of the 2020 Warriors of Wrestling King of New York and earned his spot through that. Here he is, the one you can count on, but you can't count out, Mr. Vinny Pacifico. Mr. Pacifico, our 2020 King of New York, you know why we're here. It's time to sign that contract and make this match final for December 5th on our anniversary show.
You know it.
Now, we're only missing one thing. Your competitor for that evening, the reigning, defending, unprecedented Warriors of Wrestling World Heavyweight Champion, the leader of a hostile collective, Mr. Darius Tart.
Never signed a contract before?
It's you first.
You don't tell me what to do.
I'll tell you what to do, brother.
You're lucky to be here, man. Don't do it.
Take a seat.
You want to address him? Talk to him. Talk to him.
No.
Hand the mic to him.
Last month.
Come on.
You threatened to put your hands on my father.
So?
So?
What's the problem? Who cares?
That was the biggest mistake of your life.
Woo! Woo! Give it some take. Come on, sir.
Vinny, you sound very upset right now.
I am.
Calm down. A lot of sugar drinks, I know. You're probably wondering what this is. Are you old enough to drink?
Just about, yeah.
This is courtesy of the Hostile Collective, just so you know. Yeah, I know you're mad, you threatened your father, I get it. This is an act of sportsmanship on our part. just so you know, it's not all about dishes and fighting and animosity. This is for you guys. A show of respect from the champ, the Hostile Collective, to you.
Boy, you suck!
Okay, now that's about as nice as it gets. Vinny, and I do want you to sit down because I want to talk to you man to man. Okay, I want you to understand what this is because honestly, I helped put this together, okay? I wanted there to be a contract signing in front of the Warrior Nation. I wanted these people to understand what's happening at the anniversary show. See, people, in most of your matches, right, it's a fun match. You do all these moves, it's cute, it's adorable, everybody claps, right?
Yeah! Come on, Trigger!
You're the kid, you come out to ridiculous 90s music, your hat is backwards, you look foolish. Honestly. And I want these people to understand what's gonna happen because this isn't just gonna be a match, this isn't just gonna be a wrestling match. I need you to understand, Vinny, that you are competing in a main event for the World Heavyweight Championship against the hottest thing going today.
You suck! You suck! You suck! You suck! You suck!
See, but if I did, if there was accuracy to that chant, I would be sitting on that side of the table. I would be sitting without a championship. I would be on the outside looking in. Now, Vinny, I need you to understand the severity of this because you won King of New York, and that's just not a tournament. That's not just some tournament that you won, you get to post about on social media for a week, okay? That makes you the number one contender. And I know that makes you smile, but I need you to ask Deanna. I need you to ask Frat Boy Favre. I need you to ask the No Limits champion, Dexter, what it means to be in the ring one-on-one with the world champion. It's not fun, it's not excitement, it's not joy, it is agony, it is excruciating pain, and it is the realization that you, as a man, are inferior to me.
You suck, brother! You suck!
See, Vinny, you want to talk about your father? Well, I'm the all-father. I'm going to teach you more than your dad ever taught you. Because when we compete in that ring, Vinny, oh, you look at me when I'm talking to you, boy. By the end of the day, this may just be another 40-second match on YouTube. So keep shaking. Yeah, you're getting upset. Good, good. Because this isn't about the kid. This isn't going to be fun, Vinny. This is going to be something different for you. You're stepping up. You understand? This is your opportunity to compete against the best. So I need you to look me in the eyes and understand that, Vinny. And that's why I want us to enjoy this. So I'm going to go ahead and sign first, Vinny. All right? Because I am going to teach you things that your daddy should have taught you when you were younger. That's what I'm going to teach you. I'm going to educate you in this ring.
You suck, Carter!
I do not suck. And I've explained why. Because again, I am the World Heavyweight Champion. And none of you are World Champion.
Shut up, Carter! You suck!
Are you? Is that a lie? Is Vinny the World Champion?
Yeah!
Or is Darius Carter the World Champion? So, with that being said, Vinny, I'm going to go ahead and sign, all right? And I want you to go ahead and put your signature on that, but before you do, Vinny, I want us to have a toast, okay? I want us to toast to the main event, because this is going to be in front of this since February?
Yeah.
Okay? Do you remember the last time we against in a singles match? That was Davey Boy Smith Jr., and I beat him. And I'm going to beat you too. But before we do that, let's have a toast, please.
No, 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 no.
Oh, no, man, I won't trust you.
Before you got one more thing to say to you. Put the glass.
But before we drink this, And before we toast to the demise of Vinny, because that's what this is going to be.
It's tasteless!
I want each and every one of you to take one last look at this boy. Because this is going to be an opportunity for one of you in the crowd, one of you in the locker room to step up because he's about to lose his spot. So this is a wake-up call for everyone else in the roster. If you want a chance against the champion, gear up, because next month is Vinny's final month as a Warriors of Wrestling competitor. Thank you very much.
Let's go, Ryback!
Come on,
Vinny, why are you stepping up this way,
Vinny?
Hey, you frustrated?
Oh,
All right, toast.
All right, let's be gentlemen. Let's be sportsmen.
Let's be sports about it. Come on. It's okay. Gamble. It. He's no threat. Trust me. He's no threat. Deanna
is
more of a threat.
Yes, he is.
I am old enough.
You cannot drink that.
Oh yeah, that's what a champion does. So Sion, you scared?
Please.
You all right?
Yeah.
All right. You look a little weird.
Do your signature so we can go home. Come on. Come on.
Don't rush me.
Oh, come on. This is your big shot, kid. Biggest match of your life. Come on.
You got it, Vinny.
What are you stalling? Are you stalling?
Sign, you good.
Sign the contract.
This is your chance.
You won King of New York. You gotta let the office down? Come on. What's wrong? Vinny, sign the contract. Vinny, sign the contract.
Are you chicken? You cowing out?
Oh, he's look at him.
He's a coward.
He doesn't want the match. He doesn't want the match. Come on. Come on. Come on. Sign it. Sign it. Sign it. Come on. Okay. What's wrong?
Are you sick, Vinny?
Are you done? Are we good?
Getting there.
Oh, you're getting there. Come on. He needs a cheer on. Cheer him on, guys. Help.
Go, 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 go. Come on, Vinny.
What, are you drunk?
You only had one.
I'm not drunk.
I've never seen a man take this long to sign a contract in my life. Do you need your dad for that too, or?
You don't know how to work that? Use your finger.
You gave him a finger.
Hey, finger. Not even your finger.
Oh, he can't even get it. Oh, what a shame. Come on, Vinny.
You don't want to wrestle.
Oh, we finally got it to work. Finally. There you go.
Good job.
All right, let's shake hands. Come on. Come on.
Be
like men.
Be nice.
Oh, wait, whoa.
I don't know if you want to shake his hand.
You
want to shake
hands?
Alright. Last call.
Oh, come on! Come on!
Let's leave him here to his thoughts. He's thinking about signing a contract.
That's not right!
want to see it.
Sad. One of you, I hope you'll step up and take your spot.
Oh. Good job, Hustle. Good job, Bill. You're
just
a
saying. Just saying.
Good job, Hustle.
Just one glass, baby. That's all it was a glass.
That poor kid.
Oh, you're already down.
You're lightweight, not a heavyweight.
Disappointing. Disappointing. I see you. I see you in the main event.
Lightweight.
Good job, Ben. Come on, Benny!
Introducing first,
weighing 211 pounds, the Galactic Warrior, Sam Shield. Next, from Staten Island, New York, here is Shuhel. And finally, from Baltimore, Maryland, weighing 205 pounds, Steelers. Of Brooklyn, New York, weighing 204.5 pounds, Mike Harvey. Weighing 177 pounds, he was the winner of the 2020 Warriors of Wrestling Lethal Lottery and Battle Bowl, Bensonhurst's very own Abraham.
I've just been informed by Mr. Steeler, if the new breed team wins, Mr. Steeler will be retired.
No!
However, should Team Standard Bearer win, Chris Steeler will be granted a chance at the No Limits Championship at our anniversary show on December 5th.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Chris Scott on the mic. This is the Warrior Series. Welcome back to Warriors of Wrestling.
Steal our bodies! Steal our bodies!
You got that off right now! I'm gonna come out there and slap every one of you!
Yes, well, Scotty Priest, very sensitive nowadays. He signed a contract. He's now Chris Steeler's sucker. That stands for Steeler's Undercover Keeper and Enforcer of Rules. Again, Steeler's Undercover Keeper and Enforcer of Rules. Joel tags herself in when Scotty was trying to tag in Steeler.
Yeah, I can't hit him.
E-Rock won't hit Joel.
I'm not going to wrestle you. There you go.
But Joel putting the strikes on E-Rock. Now E-Rock is gonna, I guess he's just holding on. He doesn't want to hurt her. But Joel with that elbow strike and a knee strike. Joel slamming down E-Rock to the mat. The pin, one. Barely a two count. Referee says it's a one. It's Chris Steeler, Sam Shields. Oof. A DDT. Joel with the pin. One, two, not enough. But yes, it is Chris Steeler, Sam Shields, Scotty Priest, and Joel up against Team New Breed, led by Abraham Khan and Dexter Obsidian, E-Rock, and Mike Harvey. Scotty Priest taken by Joel, and there's a strike to the rib. Snapmare takedown. And Scotty Priest, a former World Tag Team Champion, Warriors of Wrestling, very experienced in these kind of contests, showing the rookie E-Rock how to get it done in the ring. Oh, big strike there by E-Rock. Double axe hand sent down. E-Rock down to the mat. E-Rock slow to get up.
Let me show you.
Once again, stipulation in this Warrior Series contest. Remember, it's an elimination match. Every single time an opponent is tapped out or pinfold, they are eliminated and the match continues. E-Rock tagging in Mike Harvey, the Last Saiyan. Last Saiyan going after Scotty Priest. Clothesline after clothesline. Scotty Priest caught him though. Spins him around. Oh man, what a strike there by Mike Harvey. Dexter Obsidian pumped up. The pin, one, two, not enough. As Scotty kicking out right on time. To repeat, once again, the stipulation for this Warrior Series contest. If Team New Breed beats Chris Steeler's team, then Chris Steeler will retire. This could be Chris Steeler's last match at Warriors of Wrestling. An eye rake there by Scotty Priest on the Last Stand, Mike Harvey. Scotty Priest has Harvey up, spinning around. Oh, it's a reversal. Oh, it's a reversal against Scotty. Harvey sending him up and down. Nice back suplex there. Scotty in lots of pain. Look at the agony in his face. Oh, what is this? Joel getting in the way. Joel getting in the way, and Mike Harvey does not want to hit Joel. Chris Steeler with a low blow. Oh, no, the referee didn't see. Chris Steeler with a dirty low blow, and Scotty Priest will take advantage. He has him down. Oh, man, head hits the mat. Here's a pin. One, two, three.
Mike Harvey has been eliminated.
The Last Saiyan is the first to go. As Mike Harvey's gone, now E-Rock back in there, sending up Scotty Priest in an angle slam there. And now he's got that, an inverted type of Boston Crab, that knee right to the back, and Scotty taps. Scotty's out. It's now a 3-on-3 contest. Joel's in now, and E-Rock going after Joel. He wouldn't go after him before, and now, oh no, and now he's got the Boston Crab. Joel taps out, and what just happened? What just happened to Chris Steeler and Sam Shields? It's now a 2-on-3. There's a lot on the line here. If Chris Steeler's team loses, Chris Steeler retires, but if Dexter Obsidian, Abraham Khan, and E-Rock can pull this out, if they will lose to Chris Steeler, then Chris Steeler will have to fight Dexter Obsidian for the No Limits belt next month. A lot on the line And you gotta think, if Sam Shields comes up clutch for Chris Steeler, maybe that money Chris Steeler was making the other day over that Zoom call, if you saw on the Warriors YouTube page, maybe some of that money he earned he's gonna give to Sam Shields for a little bit of a bonus. Look at this. E-Rock spinning around, sending him down a head scissors takedown. Shields in trouble. Drop kick there. Shields looking confused, tripped up. E-Rock has a whole leg. Can he try to get a third? Will he try to get a third elimination via tap out? Oh no, kicked in the skull. Sam Shields has him up and a scoop slam. The other thing to mention here is if Chris Steeler's team wins, then Chris Steeler will get all the pay for this match from Dexter, Abraham Khan, Mike Harvey, and E-Rock. He mentioned that on the YouTube channel. Now Steeler kicking the life while Shields holds back E-Rock. Chris Steeler got a lot of fight left in him. If this is his last contest, he's gonna go out on a high note. Oof. Another chop there by the young E-Rock. These two tagged together recently. Oh man, another strike. Look at E-Rock go. Steeler can't get up. Look at all these strikes by the young E-Rock, the rookie. A reversal there by Steeler, sends him into the corner, but he holds himself back, gets that foot up in time. Oh, right into the jaw with that elbow strike by E-Rock. E-Rock has a hold of Steeler's leg, trying to get a third man to tap out, but Steeler quickly can bring him down, reversing the pressure, and oh no, E-Rock's got it locked in. Steeler tap? This could be his last match in Warriors of Wrestling. He's got to get to the rope. He's crawling, he's trying, he can't get the tag. Oh, he got it, right on time. Sam Shields back in this contest, quickly going after E-Rock. E-Rock slow to get up, really just a lifeless body at this point, as Shields brings him down with that Northern Lights type of suplex, but just a two. Shields thinks it was a three. It was pretty close.
Come on, E-Rock, come on!
So much on the line. If Steeler's team wins, he gets a No Limits title shot against Dexter Obsidian. If Team New Breed wins, then sayonara Chris Steeler. Steeler will retire. And of course, Steeler and Sam Shields will get the pay of their opposition if they come out victorious.
Yeah, it's over!
Sam Shields has a hold underneath the arms, but wait a minute, E-Rock with the reversal, trying to go for another submission maneuver. Sam Shields not letting it happen. We've seen how devastating that submission can be. And what's this? It's a pin attempt. It looks like his shoulder was up there. Yeah, his foot was underneath the shoulder. Going after the leg is Shields. E-Rock slow to get back up. Sending him up, and down goes E-Rock. Nice move there. One, two, three. Sam Shields coming through for Chris Steeler. It's now a two-on-two contest. Sam Shields locking eyes with Dexter Obsidian and realize that Steeler wants him. What is this? What is this? Shields calling for a timeout. Shields and Steeler outside the ring. Looks like they're game planning here. I wonder what they're talking about. Dexter Obsidian doesn't even want to waste any time. He wants to go ahead to the two. Referee on a four count. Right now, Shields is the legal man. No tag was made. Shields is in, and they're gonna go with Shields. As Dexter Obsidian, the No Limits champion, in the ring for the first time in this contest as the legal man for Team New Breed. Abraham Khan hasn't been in this contest yet. He's on the apron behind Obsidian. It's a two-on-two contest at this point in this elimination match of Warrior Series. Shields has the advantage, but Dexter trying to get out of this headlock in the middle of the ring. If you're Shields, you keep Dexter close, because Dexter's very fast. He'll jump off the ropes. If you're Shields, you're big and strong. You want to wear down Dexter before he can really mount any offense. Shields keeping Dexter in tight, but Dexter launching those elbows into the gut. Bouncing off the ropes is Dexter. Oh, he got a shoulder block on him. Oh, quickly rolling out his Shields. And Steeler's ready. Steeler is ready. And what could be one of the last times he enters the ring if his team loses. Wants to put it in his own hands. And here we go. Oh, big knee strike there. These two have been talking a lot of smack to one another over the last months. And look at these strikes by Steeler.
How does your chin feel?
Oof. Oh, man. Look at the aggressiveness of Steeler. Sending the No Limits champion to the corner. Oh, disrespectful slaps going back and forth. Now Dexter Maddox some offense, an uppercut there. Steeler misses that strike, bouncing off the ropes, and there's a drop kick. Steeler bouncing in and out of the ring very quickly. And what is this now? He's got a hold of the waist, bouncing off the ropes, rolling over. Steeler's down. Dexter quick to get up, and a double knee strike to the head. The pin on Steeler, one, two, not enough. The No Limits champion almost was able to eliminate Chris Steeler. Dexter going to the corner to get Abraham Khan tagged him, and this is the first time we're seeing Abraham Khan in a ring since winning the Lethal Lottery and Battle Bowl last month. He has a guaranteed title opportunity in 2021. So it's safe to say the stock is rising on the young Abraham Khan. Big knee strike there on Steeler, and a DDT. Abraham Khan looking to eliminate Steeler. Two, not enough. Steeler kicking out right on time. Wouldn't it be something if Abraham Khan was able to get rid of Steeler? As Steeler was one of the final three in the Battle Bowl last month, it came down to Abraham Khan, Roger Mendez, and Chris Steeler. And Dexter Say, the No Limits champion, has Steeler stuck in his team's corner, quickly tagging in Khan. These two operating like a real team. Looked like Khan's leg was stuck there behind Steeler. Look at these strikes. Khan full force ahead. A nice strike to the head. Snapmare takedown. Lining him up. Bouncing off the ropes. And he hits him with that diving uppercut. Steeler down the mat. One, two, not enough. Steeler kicking out right on time. Khan keeping the pressure. Steeler slow to get back up, but he's back to his feet. Khan driving him into his team's corner. A Dexter Obsidian tag back in. The No Limits champion jumping over the back of Khan. Hits that knee strike clean. Going for the pin is the No Limits champ. One, two, not enough. Steeler kicking out right on time. Ooh. Steeler able to mount some offense there. Was really taking a beating by Obsidian and Khan. And now Sam Shields tagged back in, looking fresh. And there's that Russian leg sweep. And he's got a hold of that leg. And he's able to use his legs to put a pin on the No Limits champion. Wow. Okay, just a one count. But you can see Sam Shields, he may be a big guy. And he may have a lot of muscles, but he can move around the ring pretty quickly. Biting the ear of Dexter. Can't do that or he can get eliminated. The referee wants the match to continue despite the illegal tactics there by Shields. Shields shoving his boot into the throat of Dexter as Steeler walks around, lines up his shot, gets ready, full force ahead, hits him with the knee strikes. Oh, man. Dexter's head. Oh, look at this cocky pin there. Just the one. Tell these two do not have any respect for one another. And Dexter tagging in Shields. Steeler picking up the No Limits champion. Shields and Steeler on the same page, executing a double suplex, nice and clean. And now Dexter is reaching for Khan. Shields going for the pin. One, two, not enough. The No Limits champion kicking out right on time. Staten Island's own Dexter Obsidian starting to fade. Sam Shields, looking fresh, has a hold there. He could tap, Dexter could tap at any moment. Shields had a lot of time to recover from earlier on. Look at these strikes, Dexter trying to break out of it now, goes after the jaw with that one. Shoving him towards the rope, Steeler tags himself in. I'm not sure if Dexter noticed. Oh, there's a shot there. And Steeler sending up Dexter Obsidian and bringing him down to powerbomb with the pin. One, two, three. Oh, Oh man, what a message sent there by Chris Steeler. Steeler throwing out the trash. The No Limits champion has been eliminated, as now the Battle Bowl winner, Abraham Khan, has a handicap match in front of him at this point. He has to take down both Chris Steeler and Sam Shields. And if he does, Steeler will retire. However, if Steeler and Shields win, then Steeler's got a No Limits championship contest next month against Dexter Obsidian. And he's got the pay of all the members of the New Breed for this contest. Abraham Khan not backing down from the fight, going after Shields and Steeler with everything he's got.
Come on, guys!
Khan pumped up as he is bringing the fight to these two veterans. Oh no, he got caught. He got caught. Shields got him, but quickly bouncing out of it. Oh, ran right into that one. Shields down on the mat in pain. Khan looking at you in this contest. Up one, two. No, not enough. Khan needs an elimination quick before Shields is able to mount some offense against him. Can Khan get Shields out quickly? That's what he needs to do. As a whole, nice suplex there by Khan. The lethal lottery winner trying to eliminate Shields. Not enough.
Come on.
I picked you for a reason.
He's got a guaranteed title shot heading into 2021. But you know Abraham Khan wants to get rid of Chris Steeler. What is this? Oh, head bouncing off of the turnbuckle. Sam Shields able to set Khan down. Now, he's got a hold. He had a hold of his ear? Look, he had a hold of his ear for a second. The aggressive Shields going into the corner and sends that forehead into the boot of Steeler. The standard bearer of Warriors of Wrestling, Chris Steeler, with Sam Shields sending Khan to the corner. Khan able to get that boot up in time as it bounces off the skull of Shields, goes after Steeler, double knee strike to the chest of Shields. Look at Khan go, giving it everything he's got. Khan saying, "You're done," to Shields, going under the arm. What is this? Oh, Shields saw it coming. Oh, big head strike. Khan down to his knee. Khan, he's done everything he can, but this may just be too much for him. Steeler signaling the end, and he hits it cleanly. Here's the pin. One, two, three. Chris Steeler remains at Warriors and has a No Limits date next month.
Abraham Khan has been eliminated. Therefore, your winners, Sam Shields and Chris Steeler, team standard bearer. And with this win, Chris Steeler is now granted a shot at the No Limits Championship at our anniversary show on December 5th.
Because he is a wrestler, Roger Mendez!
175 pounds, here's Max McCain. And you have the certainly athlete from Las Vegas, Nevada, at a total combined weight of 365 pounds. First fight, shut it out.
Here we go, another contest for the Warrior Series. I'm Chris Scott from Warriors of Wrestling. Joey Ace back in a Warriors of Wrestling ring. Oh, a vitamin R there by Roger Mendez on Anthony Vibe. He was not the legal man. That vitamin R cutter. Max Bain from the top row with that frog splash. The pin, 1, 2, 3. Anthony Vibe's been eliminated. Team 5-star down to 3 men. The Fighting Spirit, Eddie, in the ring. And Team Roger, made up of Max Bain, the Midnight Classics, and of course, Roger Mendez. Going up now against the Fighting Spirit, Eddie. Oh, nice. Wow. Nice suplex there. 1, 2, not enough.
Come on, ref.
Joey Ace.
Ref, come on, dude.
Alongside Ivan the Goat with the Fighting Spirit, Eddie.
Come on, bro.
Making up Team 5-star. As Anthony Vibe has been eliminated. Max Bain getting that leg up. Couldn't get that full suplex, but instead goes with a DDT on Eddie. Dragging Eddie over to his corner. And one half of the Midnight Classics and the former World Tag Team Champions, Justin Adams, in the ring. Now, of course, Justin Adams and Chris Romano have a date with Joey B and a mystery partner next month in their tag team contest. Adams and Joey B have been going at it over the last few months. They had a big brawl not too long ago. That kind of set up next month's match. But who will partner with Joey B? That's what everyone's looking to ask. They're trying to find out who will he partner with. Big spine buster there by Adams. And Eddie has been eliminated. Team Roger. Oof. Justin Adams looking pumped up. Now going after Ivan the Goat. Ivan can't mount any offense since getting in. Team Rogers got to be loving this as Justin Adams trying to go for another elimination. Doesn't get it. Goat kicking out right on time. Ivan set to the corner. And there's the other half of the Midnight Classics. Chris Romano. Ron's wrestling for a long time. I'm sure he's going to enjoy next month as he gets a chance to beat the life out of Joey B. Oof. And here we are 1 month before the anniversary show. As this is a primer for Chris Romano and the Midnight Classics. Sent it to the corner. Whoa, leaping out of danger is Ivan and bringing down Romano. Ivan trying to get rid of Romano. One, two, not enough. Team Roger still has all four members of their team. Look at Roger Mendez look on in shock as he sees Ivan taking the fight to Romano. Ivan and Mendez tagged before, they tagged as a team before in the pre-shows a while back. Now we're on the main stage here. Romano bringing the fight to Ivan, shoving that shoulder into the gut. Joey Ace is begging for the referee to call a match down the middle. Referee distracted and, oh man, that head bouncing off the top of the turnbuckle. Ivan in trouble, stuck in the corner with Team Roger. Justin Adams choking out Ivan, and look at Roger Mendez now holding onto the leg. Oh man, Joey Ace is pleading his case, saying, what are you doing? He's got every right to be angry. Oh, sidewalk slam by Romano. The pin, one, two, not enough. Ivan kicking out in time. Ivan's got to get to Joey Ace, as it is now a 2-on-4 contest. It's soon going to be a 1-on-4 match. Head butt to Ivan.
Yo, man, come on, tag me.
Ivan's now sent into Team Rogers' corner. Joey Ace just yelling, tag me, bro, tag me. Max Bane in the ring. Oof. Sending down Ivan. Oof. Max Bane from York, New City. Strikes to the back of the head. Max Bane in control against Ivan.
Oof.
Ivan slowly get back up. Max looking to put him away. Max going with that suplex. He hit it. Here's the pin. One, two. Nope, not enough. Ivan kicking out right on time. Max frustrated with Joey Ace. Trying to get the tag off. Couldn't do it. Ivan sent into the Team Roger corner. The referee distracted once again. What is going on here? The referee not paying attention. It's a triple team on Ivan. The referee not able to see it at all. Team Roger loving it. They could go for a sweep here, but Ivan mounting some offense against Romano. Here's a drop kick by Ivan. Romano sent flying to the other side of the ring. Oh, big, big strike to the gut from that knee. Now going out to the back. Romano getting control back. Bouncing off the ropes. There's reversal. Romano saw it coming. Hits the DDT clean. That's got to be it for Ivan. One, two, three. Oh, man, Joey Ace.
Ivan Costa has been eliminated.
Joey Ace now has to go up against Team Roger all alone. All Joey Ace wanted was to go after Roger Mendez, and Mendez staying on the sidelines. Yes, Joey Ace. Joey Ace, a veteran, a former champion here at Warriors of Wrestling, No Limits champion. It is 4-on-1. Joey Ace bringing the fight. Now going after Adams. Going after Romano. Roger Mendez escaping the ring. Romano is the legal man. Joey Ace fired up. Sending Romano off the ropes. Big drop kick there. The veteran Joey Ace has returned to Warriors of Wrestling. He's all alone. in this elimination contest. He has to eliminate four competitors to walk away victorious at Warrior Series. Bouncing off the ropes as Adams runs into that elbow strike by Ace. Max Bane gets in there. Oh, now just beating the life out of Joey Ace, who didn't see him as he got struck in the back. I didn't see when Max Bane tagged in. I didn't get a chance to see it, but the referee is saying Max is the legal man. So I'm going to, I guess, believe that Max is legal. And Joey Ace getting choked out. He's all alone. He's got no one to tag. He's got to find a way. He's got to get quick eliminations. But Max Bane is keeping the pressure. He's got to hold the hair and look to see Joey Ace do whatever. Yeah, you'll see Joey Ace do some dirty moves, especially because the referee has not been calling this one down the middle, in my opinion. Big strike there by Bane. Another one on Joey Ace. Ace trying to contain the fight, sending down Bane, and now just mounting him and just getting strike after strike after strike. Bane defenseless on the mat. Joey Ace has a real problem with the referee, and it's warranted.
Don't look in your face like that, ref.
Bane driving Joey Ace into the Team Roger corner, and oh, this is not a good spot for Joey Ace. Roger Mendez tags himself in, and now licking his chops, just mounting strike after strike against his arch rival.
Shut up.
The last time these two fought each other, it was a street fight that made its way into the ring from outside in the parking lot. They hit each other with everything they could, but eventually Mendez walked out victorious, and somehow, some way, Joey Ace, I guess, rose from the dead. He's back here. Roger with a big knee strike on Ace. Oh, I'm sure Joey Ace just wants retribution. He would love to knock out Roger. Look at these chokes as he pushes up. The cocky Mendez has had enough. He's going to tag in Adams. It's interesting. I guess Roger didn't want the honor to put away Joey Ace again. So Adams back in there. One half of the Midnight Classics. A month away from a big match against Joey B and a mystery partner. Going up now against Joey Ace. Adams ripping the shirt off and using it to choke out Joey Ace. Referee was at a four count, almost eliminated. Oof, strike to the rib. Very aggressive Justin Adams with a hard strike. Send Joey Ace up with that slam. A nice driver there. What is this? What is this? He hit a driver, and Joey B's had enough. He's had enough of Justin Adams playing games with him. He's had enough. There's a stunner by Joey B. Luck recover on Roger Mendez, another stunner. What is going on? And Chris Romano, there's a stunner. The referee just looking at Joey B. Justin Adams gets caught by Joey Ace. Adams looking. Oh, sent to Joey B with the stunner. That's what you get for hitting the Joey driver without permission. Oh, what is this? A stunner on Joey Ace. Joey B sending Joey Ace on top of the Midnight Classics. The referee, 1, 2, 3. Oh, look at that.
Chris Romano. And first class, wow. Justin Adams have both been eliminated.
Justin Adams hit a Joey driver. Joey came out and wrecked havoc.
Wait, what?
Both the Midnight Classics have been eliminated, Mr. Bane.
What?
Both members of the Midnight Classics have been eliminated. It's now a one-on-two contest. As it's Max Bane and Roger Mendez up against Joey Ace. These two promised to finish the job. They promised to finish off Joey Ace in this contest. Now they have a chance to do so, 2-on-1. And wouldn't it be quite the comeback if Joey Ace ended up victorious? Of course, the story will be with the help of Joey B, who's had enough of Justin Adams and Chris Romano. Joey Ace in pain. Max Bane will be the legal man for Team Roger.
All right.
Let's see how much life Joey Ace has left in him. He's taken quite the beating. He also got hit with the stunner, by the way, as Joey just stunned everyone. Everyone but the ref. Ooh, oh. Axe getting that strike. He kind of faked him out by calling on Roger, but Roger never got in the ring. Axe Bane bringing the fight, but Joey Ace with the reversal, a big chop to the chest. Mendez pleading for Bane to get back up. Joey's trying to put him away quickly. I don't know how much fight he's got left. I don't know if he can get another elimination. So far, Team 5 Star has not technically, legally eliminated anyone. But with the help of Joey B, it's now a 2-on-1 contest. Another chop there by Joey Ace.
I missed that one. Come here. Yeah, you did.
He's not getting clean chops. I think he got that one, though. Oh, he wants another one. That's another one. Another one. Another one. Another one. Joey Ace aggressively grabbing the head of Max Bane, trying to put him away, smiling at Roger Mendez, saying, "You're next." What is this? What is this? Oh, is that a low blow? That looked like a low blow. That was a low blow by Max Bane. Joey Ace, he grabbed the ref, was yelling at him. The next thing you know, it's a low blow by Max Bane. And now Max is saying, "Finish him, Roger, finish him." If Roger hits that vitamin R, it is over for Joey Ace. He's sending him up. He's got a hold. Oh, but Joey Ace pushing him off, sending Max Bane, who was stuck at the top of the turnbuckle, falling and crashing down. Joey Ace with a big opportunity here to even the contest. And he hits that running leg strike. And a running kick. Max Bane rolled over to the center of the mat. And Max has been eliminated. Now it's 1-on-1. It is Joey Ace and Roger Mendez. What is this? Mendez crawling into the ring. Joey doesn't realize it. From the back, Roger's got him up and bringing him down. And going for the pin is Roger. 1, 2, not enough. Mendez promising to finish the job and end Joey Ace in his return to Warriors of Wrestling. Mendez mounting with strikes, looking on, circling his prey. You know he wants to hit that cutter, the vitamin R cutter. Roger picking up. Joey Ace from outside the apron, launching him back into the ring, cleanly executed. A beautiful suplex there by Mendez. What is this? Oh, wait. 2, not enough. Playing games with Joey Ace. Got a hold. Got the head underneath the arm. Spinning him over 1. Not enough, just a 1 count. Mendez frustrated. Joey Ace continuing the fight. He was stuck 1-on-4. He was the lone man on his team, Team 5 Star. He was the lone man, and somehow, some way, we've ended up in a 1-on-1 contest. He's got the arms tied up with the ropes, and there's a chop there by the veteran Joey Ace. Headlines tomorrow are going to read Joey B wrecking havoc in Warriors of Wrestling, stunners for all. Then he dragged Joey Ace's body on top of the Midnight Classics to eliminate both of them. And look at that free fall drop executed by Roger Mendez on Joey Ace. Ace on the mat at a 2, kicking out a 2 count. Mendez really nursing that chest as Joey Ace continually was chopping him. 1, 2, not enough. Joey Ace has to use the ropes to get back up. He's starting to fade. Mendez looks like he's in pretty good shape. Could be running on adrenaline at this point is Joey Ace. Mendez has a hole in the gut. He's off of the ground, and he hits that suplex. Not sure if he got all of it, but the leg got him to stop the impact. Here's the pin. 1, 2, not enough. Joey Ace barely kicking out there. Mendez looking on and sees that the end is near, but he's got to be careful. Joey Ace is a veteran. He knows how to do this. Roger's still young, so I wonder to see if Roger may get too cocky. tends to do that. He's got a hold of both ears. There's a low blow by Joey Ace, and the ref didn't see it. Finally, Joey Ace has caught a break. He's caught a break. He executed a low blow on Mendez. The referee has no idea. And Mendez is rolling away. He's rolling away from Ace. Ace going for the pin. One, two, not enough. Joey's slow to get back up. Both men slow to get back up. Mendez driving Joey Ace into the corner. And now just driving those shoulder, one by one, right into the gut. The end has to be near. These two are just really laboring right now. Another suplex with assistance of the ropes. Oh, man. Three and two got a kick right to the tuchus. Gonna have black and blue there tomorrow. Joey Ace slow to get back up once again. Stuck in the middle of the ring. Big knee strike by Mendez. Trying to put away Ace. What's he gonna do? Bouncing him off the ropes. He's trying to set up that vitamin R. What is this? Big move there! Whoa! Whoa! What? What was that? Crazy, crazy move. And look, Joey Ace. We've seen this many times. The elbow drop. Oh, he hit it all. He hit it all. The pin. One, two, three. Joey Ace has come all the way back to beat Team Roger.
Roger Mendez has been eliminated.
Nice.
card, weighing 160 pounds, Sir Tyler. And from New York City, at a total combined weight of 450 pounds, they are your great, defending Warriors of Wrestling Tag Team Champions, Jack Gallow, Jason Kidd-Todd,
of Wrestling. Thank you very much for joining us in our first contest of the evening. It'll be Prolific and Hush Holiday going up against the rookie James Tyler.
Let's clap up for rookie. After this, you ain't gonna see his ass anytime soon. After this, you are not gonna see him anytime soon. Come on.
James Tyler paired up with Team Talent, Isaiah Wolf, pointing out once again that Tyler is very young. He's a rookie, and Isaiah Wolf cocky early on. He's very egotistical. He's gonna get in Tyler's head. That's exactly what he's planning to do here. We've seen this for years at Warriors of Wrestling, and it's got Wolf pretty far. The biggest thing that Isaiah Wolf has, though, is his athleticism. And you can see that he's got some strength. He may have a strength advantage against Tyler. Wolf, a former tag team champion and No Limits champion multi-time for both. Tyler with the advantage has a headlock on Wolf. I'm very intrigued by this matchup in particular between these two, as I see a young Isaiah Wolf and Tyler in terms of his athleticism. He's not as vocal as Wolf, but look at this display here. Wolf tugging for cover, but he gets caught on that reversal of an arm drag. And Wolf backing off, trying to reset the pace. Very vocal now. It's just a reversal, folks, but Tyler seems to be taking this as a victory because he caught Wolf, so I guess that helps his confidence, but he's got a match to win. And Wolf quickly disrespecting Tyler with that slap in the face, and Tyler brings it back to Wolf. Another slap in the face by Wolf. These two are just going back and forth. I think we're about to see some fireworks. Strikes missing by Wolf. Tyler talking for danger, but there, he caught him. Wolf caught him with that gut kick. Wolf sending him over the shoulder, but there's a reversal. Kick to the gut to Wolf. Tyler's got his leg on the neck of Wolf. Wolf ducking for cover, and now he's gonna hold the arm, and there's that arm drag takedown. Wolf for another one, he brings him down. And Wolf caught him, he's got his legs, got his arm. Tyler's skull bouncing off of that knee of Wolf, and that's the biggest move so far in this contest. It's early on, but Tyler seems to be fading, and a backcracker. Nice combination there by Isaiah Wolf. Going for the pin, this could be it. One, two, no, not enough. Tyler kicking out, but he's gotta get to Team Cal, who's in his corner. The defending world champions in the tag team division need to get back into this contest now. They need to get in. Tyler is damaged, and Wolf sees it. Wolf sees his prey, sends a knee strike into the gut. Not sure if he got all of it, but I think he's going to try to strike the head now. Going for it again, misses it. Oh, knee right to the top turnbuckle. Tyler taking advantage. A strike, and there's another one. Hard hit. Oh, Tyler missing that high strike. Wolf backing away. Now Wolf sees Tyler sitting there. Oh, man. Knee to the skull. That could be it. Here's a pin. One, two, three. And that is it for James Tyler.
Tyler has been eliminated.
Tyler came in hot, but Wolf caught him. And now James Tyler eliminated. It'll be Team Talent left against three members on the opposing team. The former tag team champions and Marcus Marquis and Isaiah Wolf of Prolific and Hush Holiday, who I think may be joining Prolific because I heard Marcus Marquis talking about teaching him a handshake, so I'm not 100% sure. I'll have to validate that. Jason Carrion. Jason Carrion in the ring now, the former world champion, a former tag team champion and current tag team champion, multi-time with Jack Gallo. Recently was in a match against Darius Carr for the world championship, did not come out victorious, but he's still setting a precedent as a champion in the Warrior locker room, being the tag team champion. In there with Hush Holiday right now. Holiday's trying to impress Prolific. Carrion does not seem phased. And oh, look at that, man. What a strike. That could be on Holiday. One, no. Marcus Marquis dragging off Carrion. Look at the size difference of Carrion. He's huge. Carrion from NYC is tagging in his partner, Jack Gallo. Gallo pumped up. Bring him down onto the knee. Carrion on the middle rope.
You son of a...
There it is, an elbow drop combination. Gallo going for the pin. One, two, not enough. As Marquis was able to break that up as Holly was kicking out. Gallo picking up Hush Holiday. Oh, eye rake. Oh, man, can't do that. Hush Holiday aggressively raking the eyes of Gallo and sending him over the top with that arm drag. Here's a pin. One, two, not enough. Gallo kicking out just in time. Oh, Hush Holiday with a slap to the face of Gallo. And there's a headbutt by Gallo to change the game. Gallo tagging in Carrion, but notice how he keeps his eye on his prey. Oof, spinning strike there by Carrion, and a vicious knee strike to the skull. That could be it for Holiday. One, two, three. We got an even contest now. Marcus Marquis quickly getting in there, taking advantage of Carrion, who wasn't looking. This is Marquis' first time being the legal man in the contest for Prolific. And now it's a 2-on-2. We got the former World Tag Team Champions of Prolific going up against the current World Tag Team Champions in Carrion and Gallo of Team Talent. Marquis sent into that shoulder strike from the apron by Gallo. Gallo with that flip sending Marquis down on the mat. And now Carrion trying to go for a neck breaker and he hits it. That one looked like it really hurt. Carrion going for the pin. Oh. Says he's getting up. Yeah, that's right. Gallo's a legal man. Carrion realized and he's helping him up. But Gallo misses that knee strike. Marquis caught him, bringing him down. Oh, man. Wow.
You must be man down.
That looked like it really hurt. Marquis keeping the pressure on.
Now
now mounting Gallo. Now choking out Gallo, and the aggressive Marquis landing right on the head of Gallo. Here's a pin. One, two, not enough. Gallo really nursing that head. Marquis got it clean. That was a game changer. Big moves by Marcus Marquis. Picking up Gallo. Gallo's in trouble. And there's a suplex. Marcus Marquis in control. Going for the pin. One, two, not enough. Gallo kicking out in time. Oh, big elbow strike there by Gallo. And another forearm strike by Marquis, keeping down Gallo. Going for a crossface, keeping the pressure on the head. Marquis looking very aggressive. Now hitting those elbow strikes in the back of the head. Really squeezing out the life of Gallo. Rolling over. That's almost a pin attempt. And wow. You see what he did there? He rolled over to bring Gallo closer towards his team's side of the mat. Now Gallo is further away from the ropes and closer to Isaiah Wolf for Marquis to tag in and stay fresh. Going for a pin attempt. Nope. Rolls him out to the side. Marquis back up. Oof, sending him down with a DDT. Oh,
that was smooth as ace.
Gallo could be done. Marquis has Gallo in the middle of the ring. Trying to signal the end for Gallo. Carrion could just look on. As it's a tag contest, Marquis on the top rope. Gallo's in trouble. Marquis from the top rope leaps down. He misses the frog splash. Gallo is still in it. Gallo still in it, getting out of the way. Marquis down. Got a two count. Gallo struggling to get to his feet. Marquis just crawling to Wolf. Gallo's up. Somehow Gallo's up. Carrion is in. Marquis gets back to his feet. This is the strike. Now we both men are in. Oh, Team Talon with a double knee strike on Marquis. Here's the pin. One, two, three. Marquis is out. And now it's Isaiah Wolf all alone against Team Talent. Carrion doesn't see Wolf in the corner. Wolf full force ahead, misses the kick. Spinning strike, misses that strike. Oh, he hit Gallo. Carrion hits Gallo. And wait a minute, Wolf about to eliminate Carrion. He did it.
Jason Carrion has been eliminated.
Isaiah Wolf with that patent knee strike, taking out Carrion. And now it's a single man contest. It is Isaiah Wolf going up against the clearly damaged Jack Gallo. What a comeback this would be for Prolific. Oh, misses the knee strike. Gallo caught him. He's got a hole in the waist. We can say Wolf go fly, and there he goes. Oh, man. Wolf down. A cleanly executed German suplex by Jack Gallo. One half of Team Talent. One half of the World Tag Team Champions. But Jack Gallo, also a former world champion. He shared that with Carrion many, many years ago in the Warriors of Wrestling history. These two, Team Talent, they are something else. Gallo full force has misses his strike. Oh! Wolf going after the knee. And there's a strike to the back by Wolf. Wolf rolling over Gallo. This gotta be it. Two. No! Gallo kicking out in time. Getting that shoulder up. Wolf can't believe it. See Jason Carrion still trying to exit the ring. He's outside. And what's this? Wolf. Wolf now fixing up his knee pads. Wolf seemed to recover. Gallo slow to get up. Gallo spins around, doesn't see Wolf. Wolf brings him up. Oh, he misses it. He misses that strike. And oh no, Gallo's got him up on his shoulders. Wolf is in a bad spot. This could be it. Sent up onto the knees. That gut just squished and crushed. Oh, and Jack Gallo's still in a lot of pain, even though he executed that. Trying to power through this. He hasn't been the same since Marcus Marquis hit that devastating maneuver on his head. What's this? What is this? What is this? Wolf. I think Wolf has possession of the Team Talent belt. And the referee is distracted. Jack Gallo saying, you gotta get out of here. And Carrion trying to get in. Carrion, I guess Carrion took the belt. Isaiah Wolf waiting for Gallo to turn around. Misses the knee strike. Gallo hits a knee strike. One, two, three. Jack Gallo taking down Isaiah Wolf.
Charge of the bell, referee Chaylin. Fighting out of Anaheim,
total combined weight of 10,216 pounds, and the King of Pain, the King of Pound Style, Red Boy Barba. And with them, from Staten Island, New York, she's your Warriors of Wrestling winning world champion, Deanna Sheehan.
You drunk him. I've beaten two of them and the other doesn't matter. This is how this is happening.
He's a punk.
You drunk Theo.
I said you don't matter. What are you gonna do about it?
What are you gonna do about it? Ladies and gentlemen,
you gonna pick
the Hostile Collective, you're welcome!
Boo yourself.
Boo you.
I hate you.
Boo! I hate Trixie.
Alright, you wanna try this one more time.
Makeup. I hate the security guy at the bodega.
And the fourth and final combat.
Maybe if you guys cheer, he'll sober up and come out.
Let's go, Angel House!
Crack Boy, Pledge, and Deanna Diaz!
What are you thinking of the crowd? He looks like a fan. He looks like one of you morons.
Looks like a fan.
Are you Vinny? Are you Vinny? Hey, you with the gimmick on. Listen.
Are you Vinny?
You're Vinny, right?
Oh, with the mask. Everybody did that.
Yeah, the gimmick.
Oh, look at that.
Unbelievable. That's it?
Let's go, Pledge!
Ring a bell!
Yeah!
They have a fourth time in the car. I've been informed by.
We want Fanny!
Sorry, we're gonna
have to. We want Fanny! We want Fanny!
I did too!
We want Fanny!
I did too!
We want Fanny!
I wanted in trouble! This isn't my fault!
Yes, it is!
Yeah, I was drinking and showing for
the show! It's all you! It's all professional!
Here,
not right. Split.
Spike them.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, the main event of the Warrior Series. This is Warriors of Wrestling. I'm Chris Scott. It is a 4-on-4 elimination contest, as these two women in the ring right now will be facing each other next month for Deanna Diaz's Women's Championship. That is Vicky and Deanna in the middle of the ring right now. Deanna with the advantage, sporting the all black. Has nice headlock there. These two have a date next month. Diaz recently was crowned the women's champion after beating Joelle a couple months ago. Vicky confident early on, the veteran Vicky, but Diaz has not seen phased. The powerhouse Diaz with that arm drag on Vicky, almost ripping her arm out of her socket. There's another arm drag by Diaz. Now, yes, there's supposed to be a fourth member here for the Fright House, and that's supposed to be Vinny Pacifico. We don't know where Vinny is, but I have my assumptions. I mean, we saw Abdul Nasir appeared to have poured something into the champagne that Vinny drank at the contract signing. Next month, Vinny Pacifico, as the winner of the King of New York tournament, he will be facing the current world champion, Darius Carter, the leader of the Hostile Collective in this match. And Vinny appeared to be not drunk, but something was off after drinking that champagne. I'm assuming he's not here because he's suffering from the consequences of whatever was in that beverage. I'm sure people will be looking into it, as obviously we don't want anyone, you know, getting to any serious harm, but I'm sure Warriors management may look into that. Diaz and Vicky were going back and forth, but now Favre is tagged in. Farva, former number one contender. Farva saying that Vinny is coming. But right now it's Fratboy Farva and the future of Warriors of Wrestling, self-proclaimed Anthony Gamble, who recently partnered with the Hostile Collective a few months back. He actually interfered and played a pivotal moment in Darius Carter's contest against Jason Carrion, one half of Team Talent and one half of the World Tag Team Champion. Carrion fought Carter a couple months ago for the World Championship, but Gamble interfered and got in the middle of it to distract Carrion. Farva now with control on that arm. Farva, another former number one contender that fought Carter and did not come out victorious. He gave it his all. I'm sure he'd like to get some vengeance here, but he's got to get through Gamble. Gamble, the powerhouse, has control of the arm. Look at the strength of Gamble. Farva able to get behind him. These two have very similar sizes. Pretty even contest here between these two, but Farva, of course, a veteran. He's been doing this for a while now. He's been in the ring with Carter. He's been in the ring with many of the top wrestlers at Warriors. A lot of experience there, but oof, hard strike there. Farva bouncing off the mat. Gamble leaping over. Farva leaping over Gamble. Ooh, nice move there. Of course, Fratboy Farva, my former color commentator. He's been taking the wrestling thing even more seriously now, as he's has a band of members of his fraternity in the frat house. You got Pledge by there, you got Deanna Diaz partnering up. They wanted to make Vinny Pacifico an honorary member. Maybe this is part of their strategy to have Vinny come in later. Pledge brought in, and he sends his body on top of Gamble. Now he's seated down. Pledge is holding Gamble there, and there is that cannonball by Deanna Diaz. Referee letting it all happen. Of course, what Pledge did was illegal by holding the leg back as not the lead competitor. Pledge tagging, Fratboy Farva tagging in Pledge. And now Pledge the legal man. Anthony Gamble crawling to his corner, the corner of the Hostile Collective. And these two have locked eyes many times over the last couple months. There's a rivalry here between two members of part of that new breed, the Warriors locker room. On opposite sides of the spectrum, one's partnered with the frat house, one's partnered with the Hostile Collective. Shoulder thrusts by Gamble. Oh, big double chop there by Gamble. Snapmare takedown setting Pledge to the middle of the ring. Powerhouse Gamble disrespectfully slapping the back of Pledge. But Pledge bringing the fight and sending Gamble into the Hostile Collective corner. He realized it's a mistake. He backs away. Vicky tagged in. Vicky tagged in and Vicky distracting Pledge. Pledge looking extra excited.
Hey, Pledge, you might actually have a chance.
It's his
problem.
Yeah. I'm just saying.
Go Sam, Slabs, go Sam.
That's what we've been working for, Pledge.
Pledge saying we always have an extra spot in the frat house to Vicky. Oh, Gamble pushing Pledge into Vicky. Vicky! Oh, big move there. One, two, three. As that head bounced off of the mat, Vicky has eliminated Pledge. So no, Pledge not getting lucky tonight at the frat house. Deanna Diaz, the women's champion, going right at Vicky and now bringing the fight to her. Referee had a pin, and I think he counted three. I'm confused. The referee counted to three, but Vicky's still in there. Vicky was not supposed to be counted out. Diaz stuck in the corner. Now Vicky attacking the back of Diaz. Constantly going at the back of Diaz now. Vicky saying that is your champion. Darius Carter recently fought Deanna Diaz in a Battle of the Champions contest. It was the women's champion going up against the world champion Warriors of Wrestling. Darius Carter's belt was on the line, and Diaz brought the fight, but Carter was able to defend it once again. Ever since Carter won the belt from Just Neff, who took it from him back at the last anniversary show. He's been unstoppable. No one's been able to put him away. Big move there by Vicky. Looked like some sort of a cutter. The pin, one, two, oof. Wouldn't it be something for Vicky, the number one contender for the women's belt, to eliminate the current women's champion in this elimination match? Yana's staying focused, but she's stuck. She's in the corner of the Hostile Collective. She's got to get out of there. Now they're in the middle of the ring. So Deanna was able to fight her way to the middle, but now Vicky bringing Deanna into one of the corners. Nice chop there, sending that boot into the neck. Referee on a three count.
Okay.
Ooh, clothesline there on Vicky. And an elbow strike. Deanna Diaz pumped up. Going for a sidewalk slam. Nope. Vicky able to get out of it. Has a hole of her head. Oh, wait a minute. What is this? A pin attempt. One, two, three. Vicky's been eliminated. Darius Carter seeing his moment on Deanna Diaz, the women's champ. There's that big boot, the pin by Carter. One, two, three. Carter eliminates Deanna Diaz. And Darius Carter making his mark in this one, quickly getting in and getting rid of the women's champion. Frat Boy Farva is all alone. We don't know where Vinny is. It's 1-on-3. Frat Boy Farmer bringing the fight going right after Carter, but Nasir and Campbell going into the back, and my poor former color commentator is getting his butt whooped in the Hostile Collective corner. He's got a lot of heart. He really does, but the Hostile Collective teaming up on Farva. Where is Vinny Pacifico? Well, feeling the effects of whatever Nasir slipped into his drink. Farva all alone, the former number one contender and leader of the frat house, stuck in there with Anthony Gamble. Earlier tonight, we did see Joey Ace come back from a 1-4 deficit, of course, with the help of Joey B. Oh, man, look at that arm. Look at that arm stretch in place it's not supposed to stretch. And stomped. Oh, man. Ow. Carter just looking on, making sure everyone realizes who the top dog is in the company, and now stomping at the back.
That's what you do to Roach.
Farva sent out of the ring. It's a 1-on-3 contest. The Hostile Collective posing outside the ring. Carter directing traffic, Carter directing Gamble to bring Farva back into the ring, but Farva's bringing the fight to Gamble. Ugh. Can't mount any offense as a 3-on-1 contest now. The frat house has had the odds stacked against them from the beginning of this contest as Vinny never came out. Vinny's got to be in no shape to wrestle now. Gamble sends Farva into the ring as the end is near for the leader of the frat house. Underneath the arm and slamming it down. They keep on attacking that left hand now, that left arm. Farva wants to get tagged in. Gamble picking up Farva, and Carter tags himself in. Gamble holding Farva there. Carter slowly looking on. The referee had a two count. Very slow. Three. Very slow to count as an illegal double team maneuver is going on there. Carter's got a hold of both legs and stomping on the gut of Farva. Carter pressing on the chest now. These two fought back in, I believe, August it was. Oh, a flying knee strike to the back. That could be it for Farva. One, two, not enough. Farva kicking out. Farva going up to that right hand now. Right on the wrist, it looked like it landed. And Carter's just taking his time as he's decimating Farva.
How do you know? He's right over there. Tag him. Tag him, Frat Boy.
trying to kick Carter to the corner, but he's got nothing left. Carter in complete control of the hostage. This is tough to watch. Oof. Oh man, this is rough to watch. As far as he's in there all alone against the hostile collective, he's giving everything he's got, but... Oh, what is this? Over the pin, one, two. Oh man, so close. Just a two count.
Put him down, Gamble.
It's gotta be one at a time. Barber's gotta take these guys down one at a time. Big clothesline there by the powerhouse, Gamble. And Gamble would love to eliminate Farva. One, two, not enough. Farva kicking out. Of course, Gamble feels like he always needs to impress the hostile collective, but Carter is sold on it. A nice diving splash. But Carter kicking out again. Nasir and Carter are convinced that Gamble has something special in him. That's why they recruited and brought him into the collective. Carter tagged back in. Gamble doing the bidding for Carter, holding that arm as Carter just dives that knee into the back, the spine of Farva. Two, not enough. Farva kicking out once again in time. Carter trying to figure out, okay, you want to keep on kicking out? All right, I'll just take off your arm. Now he's got to hold those fingers. Oh, man, bending it back. Ugh. Farva screaming in agony. Look at how that arm is bending. Oh, my goodness. Oh, man. Oh, he's got a, I think he just broke his elbow. Oh, my. Oh, again. A brutal decimation of that arm. And, oh, man! Oh, this is so hard to watch. Oh, why did I get into the profession of being a wrestling commentator? Oh, oh my, that arm. Farva stuck in the middle of the ring, no one to tag, as Carter and the Hostile Collective just keep abusing him like a rag doll to send a message to Vinny Pacifico, who Nasir drugged up, let's just be honest. A body splash there by Gamble. Farva is just, he's got no fight left. He's done. Farva's done. There's nothing he can do. Nasir getting some action here, rolling over, setting his head down, and that double, man, a double stomp to the chest.
All right, to the corner.
The referee has lost absolute control. The referee's doing nothing. The referee is doing absolutely nothing to stop the hostile collective on this 3-on-1 assault. What is going on? What is the referee doing? Nothing. What is this referee paid off by the collective? Farva getting out of the way. What is this? Gets out of the way from that Gamble attack. And now he's got Nasir up there trying to get the bottle opener, trying to hit it. Send him into the corner, actually. He sends Nasir to Gamble. Carter misses the big boot. Farva's got a hold of the waist. Going up to the back. And a German suplex by Farva on the world champ. That may have been the only fight left that Farva had. But it looks cool. I respect it. This referee has done an awful job at officiating. He's just let the three members of the Hostile Collective stay in the ring. Do we even know who the legal man is at this point? We're at a six count. It's a three. Whoa! Look who's out! Look who's here! It's Vinny Pacifico! Vinny Pacifico! I mean, what? Wait, he's okay? He's here? Vinny Pacifico's here? Vinny Pacifico! Oh, what? Darius Carter looking on in absolute shock right now as a fresh Vinny Pacifico has entered the contest. The number one contender, Vinny Pacifico, is here, and he's ready to fight. Oh no, he's feeling the effects. He's feeling the effects of whatever Nasir put into that drink. Farva pushes Vinny out of the way, and now Farva's got second wind. Second wind by Farva. Gamble back up. Oh, now Gamble going after Farva, sending him off the ropes. Up he goes, a Samoan drop by Gamble. Nasir telling Gamble to go after Vinny. They just use Gamble like a monster on command. Ugh. And he has no problem with it. Campbell looking to pin Vinny, who's just entered the contest, too. Vinny kicking out right on time. Definitely feeling the effects after being drugged by Nasir, but he's got some fight in him. You can never count the kid out, but you can make the exception at this point. He's in the contest, but he's clearly not at 100%. Oh, he's got the arm. He's got the arm. He's got the cross. He's trying to get the crossface. He's got it in lock. Gamble stuck in the middle of the ring. Corner is trying to reach, and oh no, Gamble has tapped out. It is an even contest. It is 2-on-2. Farnham taking himself in, giving Vinny a chance to catch his breath as a certainly depleted frat boy Farva is in the ring, continuing this fight. And here's Abdul Nasir.
He looks a little sick.
What are you gonna do? Ooh. Big chop by the leader of the frat house and the former world champion Abdul Nasir. The two of them going out in the middle of the ring. Back and forth they go. Strike after strike. Who will fall first? Who will blink first? That's off the ropes, goes Nasir. Oh, what is this? Farva's got him up. He's trying to hit the bottle opener, but Nasir saw it coming. Sends him to the ropes, picking up Farva, and he's trying to get the spine buster, but Farva's holding on for dear life and sending Nasir into the ropes. Nasir could not execute it. He'll have to try again. What is this? He's got to hold the leg. Go for the pin. One, two, not enough. Nasir kicking out in time.
Come on, Nasir. Come on, Nasir.
Farva trying to signal in. He's going to try to go for the bottle opener again, I think. He's got him up. Nope, nope, nope. Nasir not letting it happen. Goes for it one more time. Nasir keeps on seeing it come. He's got to hold the eyes. Setting Farva off the ropes. Picking him up. And there's a spine buster. There it is. One, two, three. He put up a fight.
Frat boy Farva.
He certainly put up a fight, but the leader of the frat house, Frat Boy Farva, has been eliminated, and now it's a drugged up Vinny Pacifico stuck in the ring against Abdul Nasir, a former world champion, and Darius Carter, the current world champion of Warriors of Wrestling. Vinny may be seeing double right now. Clearly not in the best shape. Abdul Nasir going up to the gut. Pacifico and Carter will have a date next month for Carter's World Championship. You can never count the kid out as Vinny's mounting some offense against Nasir. Carter's talking with the crowd, but Vinny's bringing the fight to Nasir. Oh, runs right into that clothesline. Abdul Nasir. Out in the face of Pacifico. Vinny, a late entry into this match. Going for the pin. Wait a minute. One, two, three. We have an even contest. It's Pacifico and Carter. Abdul Nasir eliminated. It's come down to the main event of next month's anniversary show. It's 1-on-1. The number one contender, Vinny Pacifico. The world champion, Darius Carter. These two have a date next month, but you know what? We don't have to wait. We're gonna see them go at it right now. The belt is not on the line, but certainly the advantage heading into the matchup could be on the line. Carter saying referee checking. Vinny wants to fight.
Come on, Vinny. Do something. Do something. This is your shot in front of everybody. You're gonna embarrass yourself?
Get him, Vinny.
For all these people, huh?
Get him.
Of all the things that Carter's done, this may be the most disgusting thing as he's drugged up his opponent from next month. And now he's trying to embarrass him in front of the crowd. He's got a sleeper hold on Vinny, who's already feeling the effects of being drugged up from that drink. He's trying to bring the fight. But Darius Carter, in a cowardly effort, now going for that sleeper hold on a man that's already in an inebriated state of some sort. The bell has rung. Vinny's out. Carter continuing this. He's got to get off. This referee, let me tell you something. This referee.
Therefore, the winner of this match, Mr. Darius Carter and Team Hostile Electric.
Let me tell you something. This referee. Darius Carter and the Hostile Collective close out the Warrior Series with a victory. It's Carter standing triumphant over Vinnie Pacifico, the number one contender. These two have a date next month at the anniversary show.
Designed to fill your mind, let you realize that the
you stop
the
Hey, playa, this is the Josh Speaks, and you're watching Warriors of Wrestling, the best independent wrestling company across the entire country. So hit the subscribe button, click the notification bell so you can know whenever they post a new wrestling video. As always, love and peace.